slain like animals. None of these stories are adding up. Maybe it's our fault. Maybe it's because we're black. Whatever it is, it's okay. Our black don't crack. I walk down the street, my Arizona and Skittles in my hand, my hoodie up, they think I am dangerous. I lie on the ground, I feel cold. Self-defense is what they call it. Trayvon Martin, to serve and protect too. I yell out, an officer approaches me. I say, help, I can't breathe. Suddenly, everything goes dark. He says he's innocent. Eric Garner, to serve and protect who? I notice an officer behind me. I pull over. He asks, ma'am, are you irritated? Everything is downhill from there. I have epilepsy, I tell him. He just doesn't care. I know my rights, so he's upset. I am found dead. 3 days later, they say I committed suicide. Sandra Bland, to serve and protect who? Even my president tells me, be confident in your blackness. But how? Even if I'm the daughter of Nigerian immigrants who's accepted into 8 Ivy League schools. Even if I'm a homeschooled black girl from Chicago who graduates high school at 11 and earns a master of 16. Even if I'm a black Virginia teen with perfect attendance. Even if I'm a black Tennessee teen who scores a perfect score on the ACT. I am still profiled. Profiled as a thug in the making, only judged by my appearance and skin tone, I am no longer a human. Is it wrong that I'm flexing my complexion? Should I hate what I see about the image in the mirror looking back at me? Should I apologize because my confidence in my complexion causes you to fear me? Should I do what you want me to do? To be what you want me to be? Well, I'm sorry. Actually, no, I'm not. I am proud, strong, and confident in my complexion. So the problem is not with me. The problem is with you. Black don't crack.